नाउ मॉलिकुलर मास एंड फॉर्मूला मास. मॉलिकुलर मास इट इज द सम ऑफ द एटॉमिक मैसेज ऑफ ऑल द एटम्स प्रेजेंट इन अ मॉलिक्यूल. हाउ डू वी कैलकुलेट? वी एड अप द एटॉमिक मैसेज ऑफ ऑल द एटम्स गिवन इन द फॉर्मूला ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर कंपाउंड. द टर्म मॉलिकुलर मास इज यूज्ड फॉर covalent compounds which are expressed in molecular form. Now coming to example that how can we calculate molecular mass of compounds. For instance, we are calculating molecular mass of water. We have done about atomic masses and chapter 3 page 44 contains periodic table where you can see and you can refer that with it. For atomic mass, for molecular mass of water, we can see that there are two atoms of hydrogen. So we are going to multiply atomic mass. We are going to multiply atomic mass of hydrogen with 2, which is its number here in the formula. Then adding it, so plus 1 is the atomic number of oxygen in the formula of water. And we are going to multiply that one with its atomic mass. Now putting the values there, 2, the number of atoms, with 1, that is the atomic mass of hydrogen, plus atomic number of oxygen, 16, and number of atoms in this formula is 1. So now multiplying it, 2 plus 16, the sum is 18, 18 amu. The unit for molecular mass is same as that we did for atomic mass, AMU. 18 AMU is the molecular mass of water. Now coming towards formula mass. It is the sum of atomic masses of all the atoms in the formula unit of a substance. The term formula mass is used for ionic compounds. Now, there is no difference between molecular mass and formula mass except the point that molecular mass refers the mass of covalent compounds while formula mass depicts or shows the mass of ionic compounds. For instance, calculating the formula mass of sodium chloride. There is one atom of sodium in the formula unit. We are going to multiply it with its atomic mass. Plus 1 is the number of atoms of chlorine here. Multiplying it with the atomic mass of chlorine. Putting the values there. Atomic mass of sodium 23. Multiplying with 1. Plus atomic mass of chlorine 35.5. Multiplying it with 1. And then adding up these values, we get 58.5 amu. We have seen this, that there is no difference in either calculations or units of these two, except this, that one represents the mass of covalent compound, while the other represents the mass of ionic compounds. What is formula unit? Ionic compounds consist of arrays of oppositely charged ions rather than separate molecules. So we represent an ionic compound by its formula unit. Ionic compounds consist of oppositely ions, positive and negative ions, that is cations and anions, held together by electrostatic forces. So we represent them by formula unit. What is it? A formula unit indicates the simplest ratio between cations and anions in an ionic compound. For example, the common salt, sodium chloride, it consists of sodium ions and chloride ions. It has one sodium ion for every chloride ion. The formula unit for common salt is NaCl. We can see in the structure that this structure consists of sodium and chloride ions joined together in specific geometric shape, a cubic shape. All the green balls, all the green shaped circles represent your chloride ions, while the red circles or balls represent your sodium ions. So these all ions are held together by electrostatic forces and they make up sodium crystalline structure. Molar mass. Definition. The mass of one mole of a substance is called its molar mass. The mass of one mole of a substance, any substance, is called its molar mass. Now here we are considering self-assessment exercise 1.8 of your book as an example. This exercise consists of four parts which are alike and we are going to solve only two, part A and B for you. The remaining two parts are for your self-test. Part A, calculate the mass of one mole of copper. Now, as we said, it is the mass of one mole of a substance, so it will be its molar mass. There is just one atom of copper and its atomic mass is 63.5. So we are going to multiply that with 1 and we'll get 63.5 grams per mole. So this will be its atomic mass. Mass of one mole of oxygen, part D. Now oxygen exists as diatomic molecule, a molecule consisting of two atoms of oxygen. So we are going to multiply that 2 with its atomic mass, that is 16. So by multiplying we get 32 grams per mole, which is its molar mass. Now coming to self-assessment 1.4 related to topics covered so far. It consists of three questions. We are going to solve question number 3. The remaining two questions will be followed by the same methodology. Question number 3. Compounds urea and ammonium nitrates are given to you and you are asked to determine their formula masses. Coming towards solution, part 1. We are asked to calculate formula mass of urea NH2 whole twice CO. Following the same strategy, there are two atoms of nitrogen. Now, looking at the formula very carefully, we can see NH2 whole twice. This 2 outside the bracket stands for nitrogen and hydrogen both. It belongs to nitrogen as well as hydrogen. So now looking at this, how many atoms of nitrogen are there? 2. So 2 multiplied with its atomic mass plus, coming to hydrogen now. Now how many atoms of hydrogen are there? 2 at its base and 2 out of brackets. So multiply these 2, we get 4. So atoms of hydrogen are 4 here. You are going to multiply this with the atomic mass of hydrogen plus, there is just one atom of carbon, so multiply it with its atomic mass. Next is oxygen, having one atom, multiplying it with its atomic mass. Putting the atomic masses in the equation, 2 multiply with 14, that is atomic mass of nitrogen, plus 4 multiplying it with 1 atomic mass of hydrogen, plus 1 atomic mass of carbon is 12, so multiply it with 1, plus 1 multiplied with 16 atomic mass of oxygen, and taking their sum we get 60 AMU, 60 atomic mass unit, the formula mass of urea. Second part of this question, calculating formula mass of ammonium nitrate NH4NO3. 1 multiply the atomic mass of nitrogen plus 4 atoms of hydrogen, multiplying it with atomic mass, plus 1 multiplying it with atomic mass of nitrogen, plus 3 and multiply it with its atomic mass of oxygen. Putting the atomic masses, 14 for nitrogen, 1 for hydrogen, 14 for nitrogen and 16 for oxygen. Multiplying and adding, we get 80 AMU, which is the formula mass of ammonium nitrate. Now, coming to a new topic, gram atomic mass, gram molecular mass, and gram formula mass. Again, it's very easy and it's very interrelated to our previous topic. Its definition says, when atomic mass of an atom of an element is expressed in grams, it is termed as gram atomic mass. Atomic mass expressed, shown, written with the unit gram will be termed as gram atomic mass. Or when molecular mass of a molecule of a compound is expressed in grams, it will be termed as gram molecular mass. Molecular mass we calculated so far. Instead of unit AMU, if I write unit gram there, now it will be termed as gram molecular mass. Just with the difference of unit, the term changed. Gram formula mass, when formula mass of a formula unit of an ionic compound is expressed in grams, it will be known as gram formula mass. Coming to its second point. Now, the gram atomic mass shows 6.022 × 10⁻²³ atoms of an element. It represents this much atoms of an element. While gram molecular mass represents the same number, this number is Avogadro's number, this number of molecules of a compound in a molecular state. The compound which exists in a molecular state means the covalent compounds. And gram formula mass represents 6.022 × 10⁻²³ formula units of an ionic compound. Gram atomic mass expresses the atomic masses of atoms expressed in grams, while gram molecular masses express the molecular mass of a compound in grams. On the other hand, gram formula mass shows the formula mass of ionic compounds in grams. For example, gram atomic mass of carbon is 12 grams. As we know that its atomic mass is 12 AMU. Now looking at these both values, there is just the difference of the unit. The atomic mass had the unit of AMU. When I replaced this AMU by unit grams, G, now this term from atomic mass changed to gram atomic mass. For gram molecular mass, we have taken the example of water, whose atomic mass, molecular mass is 18 grams. So, as we knew that its molecular mass is 18 AMU, so when we replace its unit AMU by the unit grams, it will be changed into its gram molecular mass. For gram formula mass, we are taking the example of an ionic compound, sodium chloride. Its gram formula mass is 58.5 gram, as its formula mass is 58.5 AMU. Now, coming to the new topic, representative particles of elements and compounds. At which species are making up elements and compounds? The term representative particles refer to species present in substance. These species are atoms, molecules, or formula units. Atoms. Like we see carbon exists in atomic state, so it exists as atoms. Water exists as molecules. And all ionic compounds, for instance NaCl, exist in the form of formula units. Elements have atoms of same sizes, and compounds are shown by the atoms of different sizes. Types of molecules. Molecules can be classified as monoatomic molecules and polyatomic molecules. The word mono means one. Mono means one, सो मोनोटॉमिक मॉलिक्यूल्स आर दोज मॉलिक्यूल्स विच कंटेन एन ओनली वन एटम इन देम, दैट्स व्हाई दे आर टर्म्ड एज मोनोटॉमिक मॉलिक्यूल्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इनर्ट गैसेस, एलिमेंट्स ऑफ ग्रुप 8A ऑफ पीरियोडिक टेबल consist of monatomic molecules such as helium, neon, argon, krypton, radon, etc. Polyatomic molecules. The word poly means many. So polyatomic refers to the molecules made up of many atoms. They may contain two or more similar or different atoms. They'll be making polyatomic molecule. For example, H2 made up of two atoms of hydrogen, O2, HCl, NH3, etc. All are polyatomic molecules. Polyatomic molecules can be homoatomic or heteroatomic if they are composed of similar atoms. They'll be homoatomic, and if different atoms, they'll be heteroatomic. For example, H2 and O2, we see these molecules consist of similar atoms. H2 having two atoms of hydrogen which are alike, and O2 two atoms of similar oxygen element, so they are homoatomic, and the next two are heteroatomic. In the figure we can see monoatomic gases, single atoms lying far away from each other, while on the other side we can see a diatomic gas, like in the example we read about hydrogen and oxygen gases. So we can see two exactly alike and similar atoms are binded together. So due to two atoms binded together, they are making up a diatomic gas, that is hydrogen gas. Now in this figure we can see the species for this matter: atom, diatomic element, element existing in atomic state, a molecule made up of many atoms held together, a molecule which is made up of more than two elements, and a molecule which consists of only two atoms there. You can say diatomic. And then we can see a compound composed of many atoms joined together by bonds, and a mixture which is composed of different species, atoms, compounds, may be diatomic, polyatomic or single elemental state. Now coming to our new topic, Avogadro's number and mole. A mole is an amount of a substance that contains 6.022 × 10⁻²³ particles of that substance. This experimentally determined number is known as Avogadro's number, and it is represented by the symbol capital N and capital A written as subscript at its base. Represented by the symbol capital N with capital A as a subscript at its base. This number was discovered by a scientist, Emilio Avogadro, that's why it is given the name Avogadro's number. Now, to understand it, it's just a representation of a quantity. As in our daily life, we use the word dozen. We use different units to count substance in our daily life. For instance, eggs are counted in the unit dozen. So when the word dozen it comes in our mind, we are very clear that we are discussing the number 12. Or when we say a rim of paper, so by this term rim, we are very clear that there are 500 papers. Just like this, a mole of a substance contains 6.022 × 10⁻²³ particles of that substance. So as dozen specifies 12, a rim of paper specifies 500 papers, or a pair of shoes represents two shoes. So a mole of a substance represents This quantity 6.022 into 10 raised to power 23 particles of that substance. One mole of a substance contains this particular amount of atoms, molecules or ions of that substance. For example, one mole of carbon is 6.022 into 10 raised to power 23 atoms, because carbon, as we read earlier, is represented in atomic state. It exists as an atom. One mole of water, a covalent compound, consist of 6.022 into 10 raised to power 23 molecules, while one mole of sodium chloride, an ionic compound, consists of 6.022 into 10 raised to power 23 formula units. So we use the word formula units because sodium chloride is an ionic compound. Now, coming to the side block, the Avogadro's number shows that it is equal to 1 mole of any substance. So 1 mole is always equal to this quantity of particles, and that quantity is termed as Avogadro's number. And 1 mole, in short, we can say that the atomic mass of an element or molecular mass of a compound, when we express it in grams, that will be called as its 1 mole. So I hope the concept is clear. This is all about our theoretical section of chapter number 1. We did with it. Now we will be moving towards the numerical section of our chapter, which is comprised of self-assessment 1.9, 1.10 and related questions from review exercise.